Well, first, I'd like to thank the organizers for the distinction of the David Marsden Lectureship. What I'd like to do in my talk today is to try to bring together a lot of different ideas and hypotheses at a very basic science level to understand the role of protein damage and the importance of protecting the proteome in many basic science and disease states. First, I think, is the very important observations over the past 5 to 10 years that it's a large number, nearly 300 different human diseases, which are all due to the appearance of misfolded and damaged proteins. And so as you look at this list, you'll find different states, metabolism, the immune system, transport, or the nervous system, and you'll see different proteins. For each of these proteins, it's been well demonstrated that mutations in these proteins lead to their instability, that misfolding occurs, that aggregates and occlusions appear, and that this seems to be an important base of toxicity. In fact, in Dr. Lang's talk that we just heard, we saw evidence of these aggregates of tau and other proteins. The fundamental behind this, literally your 1 minute of biochemistry 101, who might have forgotten it, is that all polypeptides share in common, regardless of the species of the organism, that you start off as an unfolded polypeptide here, you then make transitions to intermediates, then you form the native polypeptides. These polypeptides then turn over through a normal clearance mechanism. And when the proteome is in a stable state, all proteins behave. The problem is the environment or mutations now alters and destabilizes these intermediates, leading to their appearance of misfolded species. One profound example is with cystic fibrosis, where the deletion of a single amino acid, delta F508, leads then to the premature clearance of an essential protein in the lung alveolar cells, leading to CF. Another example is with alpha-1 antitrypsin, where the mutation now leads to improper trafficking, and the result is, of course, emphysema. What I think all of us are brought together by are these diseases of toxic folds, as reflected by Parkinson's disease and Parkinsonism, Huntington's disease, ALS, and Alzheimer's disease. And in each of these cases, these toxic species are a direct consequence of the accumulation of misfolded and damaged proteins. And we know that there's a class of proteins that are as ancient as all of biology. You know of them as molecular chaperones or heat shock proteins. These proteins are essential to capture proteins as they misfold and to prevent them from being damaged. In doing so, what the chaperones do is they facilitate the formation of the native state. So the emphasis is really on misfolding and this idea of proteostasis, that there's a large network of genetic interactions that if we understood them well, we could apply that knowledge and develop a therapeutics to actually prevent misfolding from happening. What I'm showing you here is a little bit more complicated slide, and what I want you to pay attention to is you'll notice that we start with DNA going to RNA, going to proteins. And that's, of course, fundamental biology. But it's been assumed that once a protein's been made, that's the end of the discussion. The problem is many proteins, alpha-synuclein, Huntington, A-beta, rapidly form aggregates, which you can see down here. And the problem is you get competition between the formation of a normal protein, the appearance of aggregates, biological degradation, and biological misfolding. In other words, it's not easy being a protein. It has too many choices, and many of these choices are very deleterious to its life. You'll notice that for every one of these reactions, we have a forward reaction and a backward reaction. What this means is we can start to understand the underlying biochemical and biophysical processes that lead to the stability of individual proteins. This, as you'll see at the end of my talk, gives us an opportunity for therapeutic intervention. So proteostasis, then, is the biology that protects the proteome. And we'll talk about how these disease-associated aggregation-prone proteins interfere with the stability of many other proteins in the same cell. And moreover, that the real challenge is trying to understand how our proteome, how our cells deal with stress and aging. These seem to be the rather profound challenges in biology. And shown at the bottom is sort of this balance, that as misfolded proteins accumulate during aging and are challenged by different disease states, the proteostasis network works hard to restore balance.